It's Tuesday, and you know what that means? It's now time for our bold review dito sa Taboo Tuesdays only on Harriet. And today we are going to be looking at Late Bloomer. This is the latest Tuesday release ng Viva Max and is starred by Rob Ginto and Erica Balagtas. So, if you want more of your bold review, please like this video, subscribe to the channel, hit that bell icon for more of your bold review dito sa Taboo Tuesdays only on Harriet, the dominant of Viva Max, the 50-50 champion. Ayun. So when it comes to Tuesday releases, medyo ano to, mga short release to. And except for the last Friday, which is 48 minutes long. In fact, Late Bloomer is actually longer for 1 minute kesa last Friday release. So, ito yung para nagiging problema ng mga Tuesday release, mga ganito. 48 minutes lang, like, kulang pa lang isang oras. Is that the adult scenes are really crammed up. Okay, there's no time to breathe. Kumbaga. And I think this is like a detriment to the product na provide Viva Max, lalo na if they will continue a trend that Friday releases as well will be 48 minutes long and not a full feature length movie. So Late Bloomer is such a victim of that. It suffers to the point na the story is very generic. The music is also very generic. And the mature scenes are also really bland. Really weak. Kumbaga. And I'll show to that when we get to the story. So, this is the story of Therese and Maddie. Maddie is played by Erica Balagtas. And she was seen at Langit-Ngit. Yun ang pagkakatanda ko na huli kong narinig ang pangalan ni Erica sa Langit-Ngit. Rob Ginto, we all know her from Showtime, from Foursome. Really, one of the top stars ng Viva Max. I consider her as one of the top mid-cards ng Viva Max. Yan. Hindi man siya totally main eventer, but she is one, yung mga sikat masyado, yung medyo may pangalan na. So, the story is about yung relationship ni Maddie sa Therese. Therese is suffering from somewhat leukemia symptoms na hindi ko ma-pronounce yung tunay na sakit, pero nasabi naman siya sa dulo ng pelikula. It's not leukemia, but it's like approaching to the point na magkaka-leukemia na itong si Rob, si Therese. And at one point, she fainted sa office and this led to Maddie, her best friend, played by Erica Balagtas, to take care of her. So, Therese, losing all signs of hope for her life, decides to play with her sex life. And ang nangyari kasi dito is, imbes na tagdan, pagtuunan niyang pansin yung true love, eh gusto niya makipagtalik na lang kasi it's been like years since she last had sex and she is like 26 years old. And I am 32 and I'm all talking about sex here, so ewan ko sa yung nito ni Rob Ginto. And she does that. Nagre-reto itong si Maddie kay Rob upang makipagtalik siya once sa isa niya ka-opisina. And then sa isa niyang kaibigan, si Aris, both of which the sex scenes are very, very mid. And then Rob also flirted with Maddie's boyfriend, si Arthur, because ex niya ata si Arthur bago kunin ni Maddie. And it didn't work out. Okay, so yeah, like that. Over the course of the movie, napapansin ni Maddie na may feelings na develop sa kanya kay Rob. And she fears na, kay Therese, and Maddie fears na yung kanyang boyfriend, which is a seaman, aalis na naman, he will not provide the ends to make her happy. Kasi LDR, no? Distance relationship. And what really happened here is that it ends up with Maddie and Therese falling in love with each other. Into the series of the, nagsiselos itong si Maddie, medyo maalanin siya, to the point na, ayun, it's like this is Copium the movie. Yung pinaka best description ko sa late bloomer. So late bloomer kasi hindi siya gumanda sa late na ano. Actually, hindi naman late yung edad ni Rob Ginto dito. Hindi naman medyo late yung edad ni Rob Ginto dito. Kaya we'll see. But late bloomer is that the feelings ni Rob late na. It ends up na nag-propose yung boyfriend ni Maddie. And then she accepts, and then she broke up kasi yung love isn't there. And she now loves Therese. And Therese and Maddie, sila lang yung nagtatulo yun sa dulo. Yeah, this is a very basic story, very short. I'm just filling up the time para sa 8 minutes. But yeah, we're going to head straight to the tier list ranking ng pelikulang Late Bloomer. So, what are we gonna give Late Bloomer ranking up? Okay, so Late Bloomer. Gulo ha. Nag-load pa eh. So is this Late Bloomer? I don't know. I'm just edging, guys. Come on. Let's see. We also have some new released Viva Max movies. So let's go through them after I gave the tier this ranking. And hindi matagal pa. Okay. So let's go to our Viva Max releases. Late Bloomer. Let's see. Dito siya, di ba? I'll give it a Copium tier. Yeah, Copium. I mean, it's not much. It's not something that I can watch again. Medyo maikli, medyo bland. Kulang sa lasa. It's like, it doesn't titillate your guilty pleasure. May pa ganun. Okay, so May 3, we will have Lady Guard. And May 10, we got Dirty Ice Cream. May 17, we got Balin sa Sayaw. And May 24, we got Kulong. And then other Viva Max lineups upcoming. Punta tayo sa baba. After na early access ata yan. Ayan, mark your calendars. We got Salafa. Okay, we got Kulong. And then Servidoras, May 28. Himas, May 31. Girl Bond, June 4. June 7, Linya. June 14 is Marino. And June 28, we got Gayuma. So this is our tentative Viva Max movies for the month of May to June. May nawala dito yung huling tikim ni Armina Alegre. Nawala siya eh. Pero yeah, that's all. That's my review of Late Bloomer. Thank you. Goodbye and good night. Bye.